Good morning, children. Let us begin with Standard 5 English Grammar, Unit 20, Active and Passive Voice. So we know that a sentence is made up of a subject, verb and object. The subject comes before the verb and the object comes after the verb. So let us read this following sentences. The first one is, the hunter shot the tiger. And the second is, the tiger was shot by the hunter. So there is some difference between these two sentences. Can you all find out? Yes. What's the difference? Then in the first, we have written the hunter first. And in the second sentence, we have written the hunter after the verb. It comes second. So in the sentence one, the subject hunter is the doer of the action. In other words, the subject of the verb acts or is active. Doer means the person who is doing the action. So the subject, the hunter, he is doing some action. Action of what? Shooting. Shooting what? The tiger. So the verb shot is therefore said to be in the active voice. So the hunter is the subject, the verb is shot, and the tiger is the object. So here, who is doing? The hunter is doing. Doing what? Shooting. And whom? The tiger. So in sentence 2, the subject tiger is the receiver of the action. So in other words, the subject of the verb does not perform the action or is not active or is passive. Here, the subject of the verb is acted upon. The verb was shot is therefore said to be in the passive voice. So if we see in sentence 1, when we write the hunter shot the tiger, we had only one verb, that is shot. Now in the second sentence, when we take the tiger first and we take the hunter after the verb also we have changed, we've added was before that shot. So, was shot becomes in passive. So, in making passive, what difference did you find than the active voice? That when the active is written, we have the subject first, verb, and then the object. But when we make that sentence into passive, the object that we had, we take it first. We make it the subject. And then we write the verb. And the subject that we had in the active voice, we make it the object and we write it after the verb. So then we can say that the sentence is changed from active into passive. So the definition of the active voice will be, the active voice denotes that the subject of the verb is the doer of the action or acts or is active. Means the person who is doing is the subject and that is the person who is doing that action. So we can say that that verb is in active. Then the passive voice denotes that the subject of the verb is the receiver of the action or is acted upon or is passive. So now in the passive sentence also, the subject, when we see that subject will not be the person who is doing something, but that subject will be the receiver of any action. So then we say that that verb is in the passive voice. Only transitive verbs can be used in the passive voice. Means now you can see an example. The active voice, the man killed the snake. So killed is your verb. The man will be your subject. The snake will be your object. When we ask the question, killed what? We get the answer, the snake. So the snake is your object and it is answering the question, what? So here this, the snake is also your direct object. And killed becomes the transitive verb. So now, how do we change this into the passive? As you can see, the snake we write first. That becomes the subject. Then killed, which is in the past tense. Before that killed, we add was. And then we write the verb killed. Then after that, when we write in the passive, after the verb, we add by. And then we write the subject last, the man. So we read it like, the snake was killed by the man. So here the snake is the receiver. The snake is receiving that action of killing by whom? By the man. So we can say that this sentence is in the passive voice. So we see that when a sentence is changed from the active form to the passive, the object of the active verb becomes the subject of the passive verb. So how do we form the passive? When we see a sentence in the active voice, we find out the verb and the object. Then that object we write first in the passive, it becomes the subject in the passive voice. Then we write the verb and then the subject of the active becomes the object in the passive voice. Now we have learned different tenses, that is the present, past and the future. So now we need to see that how we need to change an active voice when it is in the simple present, present continuous and the present perfect. So let's learn about that. So now talking about the present tense. Now see the example of a simple present sentence in the active. I see a dark cloud. Now I is your subject, see is your verb one, and see what? A dark cloud is your object. So how do we change it into the passive? So children, we need to remember that whenever we make any active voice into passive, we use only verb 3, that is the past participle of the given verb to us in the sentence. So now, this simple present, how will we change it into passive? We saw that the subject is I, verb is see, and the object is a dark cloud. So now when we make it into the passive, we will take the object first. So a dark cloud we start with. Then see is our simple present. Now before that see, we have to add is, are or am. When will we write is? When this object that we have written first is singular. So we will write is. If our object is plural, we will write are. And if our object that we have written as a subject in the passive is I, we will write am. Then this see, which is verb 1, we will change it into verb 3 and it will become seen. And then at last we will write the subject that was in the active, that was I. That will become the object in the passive. So our sentence formed will be, a dark cloud is seen by me. After the verb, we need to add by in the passive. And that I, a pronoun, I, when we make it into the passive, it will become me. Now the second example. Tom kills a snake. That is an active. So Tom is your subject, Skills is your verb, which is verb 1 in the simple present. And a snake is your object. So, when we make it into the passive, what will we do? We will take the object first, which will become the subject. So, a snake will come first. Then, a snake is singular, so we will write is. Kills is verb 1. We will now write verb 3, which is killed. Then we will write by. And last will come the subject, which is the object in the passive, Tom. So your sentence formed will be, a snake is killed by Tom. Now your third example. Cats catch mice. Now cats is your subject. Catch is your verb and mice is your object. Now when we change it into the passive, the object comes first, which becomes the subject, mice. Now mice is plural. So we will write R. Catch, which is verb 1, will become verb 3. Caught, then we write by. And last will come the subject of the active and it will become the object here and it will be cats. So we read it as, mice are caught by cats. Now let us see an example of the present continuous. How do we form the present continuous? We write the subject, then we write is, are, am, then we write verb 1, then we add ing, and after ing we add the object. So this is the formation of your present continuous sentence. Now, how do we change a present continuous sentence, which is an active, into passive? So, this example is, she is writing a letter. So, she is your subject, is writing is in the present continuous tense. Then, a letter is your object. So, now, when we make it into passive, we write the object first, that is a letter. Then, we add is. If the letter is singular, we will write is. If your letters was plural, we would have written are. And if it is I, then we write am. So here our letter is singular, so we write is. Then we add being, B-E-I-N-G. When we are making any present continuous into passive, first we write is, then we write being. Then we have to write the verb 3 of writing, that is written. Then by, and then comes the subject in the place of the object, that was she. So she pronoun, she is a pronoun, that she changes into her when we write it in the passive. So your sentence will be read as, a letter is being written by her. Now we have to see the example of present perfect. How do we form a present perfect sentence? We write the subject, then we add has or have, then we write the verb 3. If you remember all the perfect tenses, present perfect, future perfect, and past perfect, they have verb 3 in it. So, has and have, after that we write verb 3 and then we write the object. So, this example is, the police have caught all the thieves. So, the police is your subject. Have caught is in the present perfect. All the thieves is your object. So, now when we make this sentence into passive, we write all the thieves first. Now, all the thieves is plural. So, we write have. Now, when we make a present perfect into passive, we need to add been after have. B-E-E-N. Then comes your verb 3, which is caught. And then will come by whom? The police. That was the subject in the active. So this is the way how we form the passive in the present tense. Now let's see how to make the passive from an active in the past tense. Now talking about the simple past, the first example, he caught the thief. He is your subject. Caught is in verb 2, which is the simple past, and your object is the thief. So now when we make it into passive, the thief will come first. Then we need to add was. Why? Because the thief is singular. If the thief was the thieves, if it was plural, we would have written were, W-E-R-E. But here a thief is singular, so we write was. And caught, the verb V3 of caught is caught. So we write caught, then we write by, and then we write him. He becomes him. So we read, the thief was caught by him. Now your second example, John beat James. So now when we make it into passive, James will come first. Beat, we will write was. Why was? Because James is a single person. Was, beat will become beaten in verb 3 by John. Now the third example of a simple past, a mad dog bit my sister. So my sister comes first, then my sister is singular, so was. Bit will become bitten, B-I-T-T-E-N, which is the verb 3, by a mad dog. Now we will see a past continuous sentence. Now the past continuous, how do we form? The subject, then we write was or were, then we write verb 1, then we add ing, and then comes the object. So this sentence also is an example of past continuous. The pune was ringing the bell. So the bell is the object which comes first in the passive. Then the bell is 1, it is singular, so we write was. And same as we did in the present continuous, we do in the past continuous. After was, we add being, B-E-I-N-G. After that, we add the verb 3, that is rung, R-U-N-G, by the pune. Now the second example, they were throwing stones at the birds. This is again a past continuous. The object, stones were being thrown by them at the birds. Now, what was thrown? Stones. So stones is your direct object. So that becomes your subject in the passive. So we write stones. Then stones is plural, so we wrote were. And then we added being. Throwing, verb 3 will be thrown, T-H-R-O-W-N. By whom? The subject, they, will become them. And at whom they were throwing, at the birds, will remain at the end. So your direct object in the sentence becomes your subject, and your indirect does not change. It remains after the verb. Now let's see a past perfect sentence. How do we form the past perfect? We write the subject, and then we write had, and then verb 3, and then the object. So this is an example of past perfect. So the object is my book. Then we add had. And then this is a perfect sentence. So we add been after had. B-E-E-N. Then we write the verb 3, that is stolen. And then comes by. And then comes the subject, someone. So my book had been stolen by someone. Now talking about the future tense. We talk about the simple future. The teacher will forgive you. So you is your object, so which comes first in the passive, you. Then we add will. Then in making passive, here after will, we will add be. And then the verb 3, that is forgiven. Then we add by and then comes the subject, the teacher. So your sentence will be, you will be forgiven by the teacher. Your next example, he will never help you. So you is your object which comes first, will never, and then be. Then help will become helped. Verb 3, by he will become him. So you will never be helped by him. I shall help her. So her will become she in the subject in the passive. Will be helped by I will become me. Then your next example, everyone will laugh at us. So us will become we, shall or will, both you can write, be laughed at by everyone. So in future we learn only about the simple future, that how it is changed from active into passive. Now as we know that certain sentences have two objects after them in the active voice. So how can we change that two objects, which is one is a direct object and one is the indirect object. So there are two ways that we can write in the passive. So let us see those examples. The first one in the active, if we say, she gave me a book. So she is your subject, gave is your verb. Gave what a book? So that is your direct object. Gave whom me is your indirect object. So now we can change this active into two ways. First, we can write the direct object first, that is a book. Gave is in the past, so we add was. Gave will become V3, it will become given. Then to me by, and then last will come your subject, she will become her. This is one way. Or we can write the indirect object, that was me, we can write it first and make it I, was given a book by her. So we can write the direct or the indirect object first and then change the sentence accordingly. The second example, we gave him 5 rupees. We is your subject, gave is your verb, gave what, 5 rupees is your direct object, gave whom, him is your indirect. Now the two ways that we can write in passive are, 5 rupees were given to him by us. We will become us. So here we took the direct object first. Now we take the indirect first. He was given 5 rupees by us. Your third example. She told us a story. She is your subject. Told is your verb. Told what? A story. That is your direct. Told whom? Us. That is your indirect object. So now how do we change? First we take the direct. A story was told to us by her. She becomes her. And now we take the indirect first. We were told a story by her. So that when a sentence, an active sentence has two objects, we can write in both the ways by taking the direct object first or the indirect object first as the subject. Next example, he teaches us English. He is your subject, teaches is your verb, teaches what? English. To whom? Us. So English is direct, us is indirect. So the first way we write English as the direct first, we take English is taught to us by him. And the second way, we are taught English by him. And the next example, the teacher gave him a prize. gave what a prize to whom? Him. So a prize is your direct and him is your indirect object. And the ways to make it into passive are: a prize was given to him by the teacher, or he was given a prize by the teacher. Now let us study the following examples of interrogative sentences, a question sentence. So in the active, if we have who broke this slate, so broke is in the simple past. So in the passive, we start by whom was this slate broken, and we again put a question mark in the passive. The second example, why did she insult us? Did is there in the active, so means again this is in the simple past. So in the passive we change it into why were we insulted by her. Third example, how did we win the prize? Your passive will be how was the prize won by him. The next one, who teaches you English? So your passive will be by whom are you taught English. The next example, who will punish you? Your passive will be by whom will you be punished. And your last example, who will blame her? Your passive will be by whom will she be blamed. Now let us start with exercise 1. We need to change the verbs in the following sentences from the active into the passive. So first we will see whether the sentence is in simple present, present continuous, present perfect, or past simple past, past continuous, past perfect, or the future. And then we will change it accordingly into the passive. So the first one, he teaches us English. So teaches is your verb which is simple present. So now, English is taught to us by him. The second one, she bought some eggs. Now bought is in verb 2. It is in simple past. So we change it and your object comes first. That is, some eggs is plural. So we write were bought by her. Third one, he rang the bell. Rang is again in simple past. So we write the bell was rung, R-U-N-G, the verb 3, by him. Fourth, she told us a story. A story was told by her to us. Fifth, who taught you Hindi? This is a question sentence. So we start by whom were you taught Hindi? And we put a question mark. Sixth, the king killed the lion. And your sentence is, the lion was killed by the king. Seventh, everybody laughed at her. Your sentence in the passive will be, she was laughed at by everybody. Eighth sentence, he showed us some tricks. So your passive will be, some tricks were shown to us by him. Ninth one, I shall not help her. This sentence is in simple future. So in passive it will be, she will not be helped by me. The tenth one, the boys enjoyed the fun. So your passive is the fun was enjoyed by the boys. The 11th one, we refuse them admission. So your passive, admission was refused to them by us. 12th, he promised me a present. The passive, a present was promised to me by him. 13th, we elected Ashok captain. Your passive is Ashok was elected captain by us. 14th, they chose him as their leader. Your passive is he was chosen their leader by them. Your 15th one, they found him guilty of murder. And your passive is he was found guilty of murder by them. Now exercise 2. Now in this exercise, we are given the passive sentences. Those passive sentences we have to make into active. So what have we done? That from active, the subject we wrote as the object, and in object is written as the subject. So now in passive, again, the subject will become the object and the object will become the subject. And the verb has to be changed from verb V3. We have to change it accordingly into the simple present or the present continuous, present perfect, or simple past, past continuous, past perfect, or into the future. So your first one, John was beaten by Jack. So was beaten, this has to be changed into the simple past. And Jack will become your subject and John will become your object. So your active will be Jack beat John. Beaten will become V2 beat. Second, by whom will she be helped? So your active will be who will help her. Third one, she will be pardoned by them. So them will become they, and this is will is there, so it will become simple future, will pardon her. She will become her. Fourth one, the tree will be cut down by him. So him will become he, will cut down the tree. Fifth one, the car will be sold by me. So me will become I. I will sell the car. The sixth one, he was loved by all his friends. So your active will be all his friends loved him. Seventh, by whom were you taught French? So your active will be who taught you French? 8th, no milk will be given by the cow today. So your active will be the cow will not give any milk today. No will become any. 9th, such mistakes are made by all his friends. Your active will be all his friends make such mistakes. The 10th one, he was laughed at by all his friends. Your active is all his friends laughed at him. So dear students, I hope you have understood this lesson of active and passive. Now you need to write the definitions and both these exercises very neatly in your English grammar notebook. So thank you and have a nice day.